Namaste everyone. Let's follow our another morning of our Hatha pranayama and relaxation yoga sadhana. Finding or choosing a comfortable pose, a posture, asana. Sitting upright on your feet in Vajrasana, cross-legged Sukhasana, or half lotus, lotus. Just to really choose a posture that you can comfortably hold. And then returning to our Savitri rhythm pranayama again. So we'll be inhaling for 6 counts, hold for 3, out for 6 and hold out for 3. Just creating this beautiful pattern of breathing to align, to intune our pranic or vital energies. Let's breathe out. In 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, hold, 2, 3, out, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, hold, 2, 3, in. In, hold, out, hold, in, hold, out. Now just let go of your breath. Hold still or sit still and just follow awareness of your own breath. To see how you inhale and exhale, and try to be aware or be conscious to your own breath, your breathing pattern. gently bring your hands to your heart, namaskar. Let's chant three beautiful Oms to begin or to move into our Hatha Yoga Sadhana. Breathe in. Relax. Change your side. Left leg is gently flexing your foot up and down. And then rotating in one direction. And change direction. Take to your leg and release, relax. Let's take our right leg or foot up against our left thigh. Pull on top of the left leg and simply bouncing off your knee. It's gracefully waking up or trying to be active. You can keep your foot on top or you can bring it up against your left thigh. And let's just gently and consciously bounce forward. It's lengthening through, reaching all the way to your foot or as far as you can reach. Keep going. Gently head down to your knee, breathe out. Breathe in, raise your arms up, lift and extend your energy. And breathe out, stretch forward, Janusirsasana. Let's keep going, breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Again, breathe in. And out. And let's do our Vakra Kriya, right arm free, breathing in, swing open from side, all the way out, open your heart, your spine, and breathe out, and it's back. Two more, breathe in, Again, breathe in and out. One more, breathe in and out. Now let's switch our sides. So holding on to the right foot with the left hand free. Out. Breathing in, swing open. And out and release back. In and out, breathe in and out, and then breathe in, reach your arms up and over, lift up, let go, release, relax. Let's shift our side. Right leg to the front, take your left foot to the right thigh or on top of your right leg. And gently and consciously bouncing off your knee. You can keep your foot up on top or you can bring it against your left thigh, right thigh, and let's just gently bounce forward. Again, gently lengthening or expanding through your spine, reaching as far as you can. Keep going. Head down to the knees, arms hip sikiriya. Breathe in, raise your arms up, lift and expand. And breathe out, stretch forward. Let's keep going, breathe in. And out. Again, breathe in. And out. Now keep holding on to foot with the right hand. So now your left arm frees. Vakra Kriya, breathe in, swing your left arm open. And breathe out, return back to forward stretch. Two more, breathe in. Out, in, and out. Now, the opposite, pravarti variation, right arm now, breathe in, swing right arm open, and breathe out, breathe in, and out. One more, breathe in and then out. And then breathe in, reach your arms up and over, expand, and then gently let go, release. Let's bring both our soles or feet together into Padmasana, bonded feet position, our soles of our feet joined together, and then we just simply bouncing up our knees. Press your knees down, hold it to Padmasana for a moment. Just taking a few breaths. And then let's see if you all can bring our mind at the root chakra and follow a little bit of our Aswini mudra. So just keep following your breath softly and then begin to squeeze, contract and lift your anal and your pelvic floor muscles and let go. So squeezing, contracting and lifting your anal, pelvic floor muscles and let go. Keep going. Gradually try to speed up. And keep going for a minute. Okay, great. Now let's just bring our chin down to the chest, press it down, and then if you like to just roll your head, moving a big circle, creating a big rotation. And then change direction. Good. Let's just turn around and come up on all fours. Take your time. Moving up on your hands and your knees into four-footed Chaturpadasana. We need a couple of rounds of Urdhva Pranayama, the tiger breathing. Head down. Breathe out. Breathing in, dip your spine down, arch your back, lift your head up. And breathe out. Lift and raise from the middle, drawing your chin to the chest. Squeeze. And let's keep going. Breathe in, dip down, open up. And breathe out. In and out. One more breathe in and out. Lovely. Return back to all fours, Chaturpadasana. Now we're going to move into a Raj Kapot Kriya with a serpent. So breathe out, breathe in, raise your right leg and your head up, create a long extended arch. And as you breathe out, draw your knee all the way between your hands, arch your back, look back, and we keep going up, breathing in, come back to all fours, raise your right leg up, create a long extended arch, and breathe out, and moving into Raj Kapot Kriya. Nice and soft, one more, breathe in and out. Now let's just hold here, take a pause, breathe in and breathe out. Come forward, rest on top of your right knee. Breathe in, lift your head, your chest, push up, arch back. And breathe out, rest on top of your right knee. Again, breathe in, arch back. Let's hold here. Then we take a bit more balance on our left arm. And then take your right arm free. Breathe in, raise your right arm up. Stretch and arch back. Out and release. Let's follow our Kriya. Again, breathe in. And out. One more, breathe in and out. Okay, then your left arm, breathe in, arch back and out. Breathe in, out. One more, breathe in. Okay, and gently step back. Taking a pause into all fours, Chaturpadasana, and then let's follow with the left leg. Breathe out. When you're ready, breathe in, raising your left leg up, arch. And then breathe out and draw your knee forward, arching your back. And let's keep going. Breathe in. Out. Breathe in out. Again, breathe in and out. Now stay here, comfortable on your arms, breathe out, take a deep in breath. And breathe out and come and rest on top of your left knee. Breathe in, press back up. Arching your spine, your Raj Kapot Kriya. And then breathe out. Again, breathe in. And out. and breathe in. Okay, this time I'm going to hold. Take a pause here. Take your balance on your right arm. So your left arm free. Breathe out. Breathe in. Raise your left arm up. Arch back. And out and release. Let's keep going. Breathe in. Out. Breathe in. And out. Taking your balance on your left arm. Right hand, breathe out. Breathe in, raise your right arm up, stretch your arms back. And out and release. Breathe in. Out. Again, breathe in. From Chatuspadasana, I like you to walk forward, come at front of your space, keeping your heels tucked underneath and sit up on top of your heels. So your toes tucked underneath, sitting up on your heels. What's the Virasana? Take a moment, have a sip of water if you need. Important to keep us hydrated. Hands to heart, namaskar. Let's breathe out here. Breathe in, raise your arms all the way over your head into Anjali Mudra, look up and breathe out your crown, Hari, Visuddha and your Anahata. Two more, breathe in, out, again breathe in, out. One more in and out. Now let's just gently take our knees up. So into a squat, Utkatasana. Look forward, breathe in, and as you gently breathing out, step back, moving to the plank, and take a breath and return back. Lovely. Again, breathe out and in and out, in and come back to Vajrasana. Okay, this time your knees up. If you can take a balance, hands to your knees. Breathe out. In, release your arms over your head, Anjali Mudra, to your crown, third eye, Visuddha, Anahata. In and out. One more in and out. And hands to the floor. So now this time I'm going to jump into our Samtula. Breathe in here. In, step or jump back. Keep going to the squat. Breathe in, return back. Again. And return back. Again, take a pause. Vajrasana. Breathe out. In, Anjali Mudra. Breathing out, crown, third eye, Visuddha, Anahata. In. Out. Hands to the floor again, take a deep in breath, breathe out, step or jump, Samtula and Chaturanga, Kokila, and then mirror. Take a moment, holding into Meruasana. If you comfortably can in Meruasana, raise your right leg up gently to the sky. Look through your arms and step your right foot forward. Lifting your hands, next left knee and foot can slightly turn sideways if you wish to. And bring your hands to your heart. Take a pause here. Breathe out. Now breathe in, open your arms and turn to the front from right side into warrior. And breathe out, back to heart, turn back to Aswatthama. Let's keep going. Breathe in, out, again, breathe in, and out, and breathe in, Anjali Mudra, and return back. Step back, Nirvasana. Taking a moment, taking a pause. And then you follow with the left leg, breathe in, raise your left leg up. Take your foot forward. Gently come up to the Aswatthasana, into the lunge, hands to heart. Let's breathe out. Breathe in, open from side to Virasana. Breathe out, back to Namaskar. Twice more, breathe in. Out, again in, and out. Lovely, breathe in, Anjali Mudra, and return back to the earth, back to the Virasana. Taking a little space to breathe consciously. When you're ready, knees down, all fours. Now take a moment here to the Svadhasana. Just a few conscious breaths. Now, in the Svadhasana, can we breathe in and raise our right leg up? Lift as high as you can reach, self-create extension. Now when you breathe out, can you take your right leg going across to the left arm or your left elbow? Okay, breathe in, raise your right leg up. And breathe out and take your knee close to the left arm. Again, breathe in. And out, lovely. And then release. Take a moment, left leg. Breathe in, raise your left leg up and straight. And then breathe out and take your left knee out and across to the right arm. Keep going. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. And release. Okay, you're doing really well. So let's try a little further. So we're going to create the twist with the leg up. So breathing in, raising your right leg up. Once the leg comes straight, twist out towards left side. So you're tilting from the hip. With out breath, I'm going to bring that knee forward and let it push through your right arm outside. And we do it 3 times. Right leg, breathe out. In, raise your leg, create the turn and the twist. And then breathing out and pushing your knee through across to the right, same side now. Breathing in, now creating the twist. And breathe out and taking your knee forward. In. And out. One more, in. And out.
Left leg, breathe out. Breathe in, raise your leg, create a turn and the twist across towards right. And breathe out, roll your knee all the way forward against your left elbow. Keep going, breathe in. And out. In. And out. One more, in. And out. And release. Now let's just gently drop our elbows to the floor, crossing them and reaching out your arms. And then push your arms forward. Nikunjasana to ease any tension of core upper chest shoulders. Open your knees a little bit and then press your buttocks further up. Turn your face to one side. And bring your face and your chest down to rest to the mother earth. And we just rest here. Gently turning back up. And then we switch side. Turn to the left, other side. Forfeited. I think you are doing really well. So let's try a little bit further. So we are just working on our arms, but mainly across our knees, hips, and our pelvic area. So what we're going to do now, we're going to take it a little further. So if I'm on all fours, and I breathe in, take my right leg up, and then pressing the knee going across to the left side, really opening through. And then with out breath, I want to take my right knee, coming out to the left arm. So some of you may just have it to the knee. Some of you can also stress your leg pointing straight. Okay, so we're going to thread the leg like coming out and to the front. It's a really typical yoga vayama. So right leg, breathe out. In, raise your right leg up. Create the twist and breathe out. Press your knee through and let it thread and go straight and then continue breathing in, following it as a kriya. And out. Again, in. And out. One more, in. And out. Take a moment, take a pause. Let's follow for the left leg. Breathing in, raise your left leg and create the turn and the twist. And breathe out and bring it forward, thread it through. Lovely. Continue breathing. Out. In. Out. One more, breathe in. And out. And then. Now, let's just gently thread our right arm on the floor, going across to the left side. Come down, rest on top of your right shoulder, face on the right side. And then raise your left arm up. As high as you can. Mari Daryasana. So you can keep your left arm up there or you can bring it down out to the right thigh. Create a steep opening and twist. And hold there. And let's gently return back up. Back to all fours, and then we switch sides. Take your left arm out and across to the right side. Take your right arm up.
You can keep your right arm up there, or you can thread it from down to the side. Create a deep conscious opening and hold there. Gently and slowly release, returning back up to your old fours, and then move up to sit up straight on your feet in Vajrasana. Taking a moment. Now, as we did quite a bit of moving forward, can we gently move back? So take your hands behind to your toes and then gently drop your elbows down. If you feel comfortable with it, then you want to go all the way back to bring back your forehead on the floor. Some of you may feel your knees are coming up, that's okay, but you want to keep your knees on the floor if possible. Vajrasana Sukta. Taking a couple of conscious breaths here. And gently and slowly sit back up and straight. Come back to your sitting position. Clasp your fingers behind and breathe out. Fold forward, let your arms stretch over and above your shoulders. Press them as far as you can and hold there. Breathe into your shoulders, your upper chest. Relax, come back up to seated position to sit upright, hands on your knees. Let's come back to one more Kriya on fours if you like. Back to Chatuspada. Now from Chatuspada we want to bring our right knee forward. So you flick between your hands. And you can choose, you can have your hands on the floor, you can bring them on top of your knee. So if you feel comfortable, maybe come up on your knee, but if you want to keep them on the floor, that's fine. So here we're going to breathe out, and as I breathe in, I'm going to go forward into the lunge, arch back, look behind. Without breath, I want to let my hands slide along, right leg coming straight, and then come and rest on top of the right knee. And we do that three times. So breathe out, right leg forward, in. Move forward into the lunge, arch back. Now breathe out, reach down to your leg, right leg straight and fold over it. Reach into the up, continue now, breathe in. Out. Again, breathe in. And out. One more, breathe in. And out. And then release. Relax. Let's take our right foot back in. Back to our fours. And then take your left leg or your left foot. You can have your hands to the floor or on your knee. Breathe out. When you're ready, breathing in, coming forward down into the lunge. And breathing out and breathe forward. Keep going, breathe in. And out. Again, breathe in. And out.
One more, breathe in. And out. And then release. Let's take it back to all fours. Okay, from here we want to gently turn around. If you all can, please find your space if possible with head to the north and feet to the south. We're going to do a little gentle floor work, basically easing our spine and our pelvic area, our shoulders. We want to lie comfortably on our back. If you wish to, let's just keep our knees bent. Bring your heels on the floor close to your buttocks. Take a moment just to feel your resting position on your back. Also your head, your neck. Our Sapurna Dvipada Utthankriya, a gentle leg raise. Breathe out. When you're ready, breathe in. Draw your knees towards your chest and then raise them up straight to the sky. And breathe out. Draw your knees back to your chest and then bring your heels, your feet back to the earth. Keep going twice more. Breathe in. Out. Again, in and out. Now your feet, your heels on the floor. We want to do a bit of kriya for our back, our buttocks, and really allowing the energy to flow up towards our heart and our chest. Setu Bandha Kriya. Breathe out. Heels to the floor. Breathe in. Raise your back, your buttocks up as high as you can go up. And out and let go and release. Again, breathe in. Out. Breathe in. Out. Now both your arms, breathe out. Can you breathe in, raise your arms up and pull the very stem over your head to the floor softly. And then breathe out and release, bring your arms back down along your feet. Now let's see if you can tune our breath. In, raise your arms up, raise them over. Out and letting go. Breathe in. Out. Taking a moment, taking a pause. Now can we do our back and our arms together? So breathe out here. Now gently breathe in, raise your back, your buttocks up, and also reach your arms all the way on the floor. Maybe even you can raise your heels up, come up on your tiptoes, and then breathe out simultaneously and back to your resting position. Let's do a few rounds. Breathe in, raise up or expand and open, and out or stay to clear. Again, breathe in. Out. One more, breathe in. And out. Lovely. Now take your hands across your heart and your chest, rest them together. Join your feet, your knees together. breathe out here. Now as we breathe in, we want to gently open our knees out, soles of our feet joining together. Also raise your arms up and open them along your shoulders. And when we breathe out, we want to bring our knees back up together and bring our hands to heart. So I like to feel we opening our pelvis by also opening our heart and shoulders together. That's 2-3 rounds. Breathe out. Breathe in. Out. In. Out. Again, breathe in. And out. Gently let go, stretch your legs straight and away, palms to the floor. Just one more gentle twist if you can. Take your arms alongside your shoulders as if you're making a T, and then breathe out. Now we're going to breathe in, draw our right knee towards our chest and use the left hand and draw it all the way towards left side. And we breathe out and let go somewhere to the middle, stress over next to it. Let's do 3 rounds with the right leg, Vakra Kriya. Breathe in, right knee up towards chest and roll it to the left side. Out and release. In. And out. In. And out. Switching our sides, let's work with the left leg, breathe out. In, take your knee up, use the support of your right hand to roll it to the left, right side. Out and release. Can we keep going? Breathe in. And out. In. Out. In. And out. Okay, and then time to let go. Now that's enough for today. Just totally let go. Gently, if you wish to bring your blanket, keep yourself warm or comfortable. So your body can really enjoy your deep conscious relaxation. Now guide you through a bit of relaxation and let it go. So you also just enjoy the nice deep relaxation. Lying straight for your body in a straight line all the way from your head to feet. And then gently and softly close your eyes. As we try to do a little bit of quite a gentle but conscious work across our hips, our pelvic area, a little bit of spinal twisting and the strengthening and arching work. So I'd like you all to now gently let go, and as you're letting go, softly draw your mind, your focus across your lower abdominal and your pelvic area. Just gently draw your mind across your lower abdominal, your pelvic area. And just pay your soft, your kind attention. As you know, yogic terms, this is our most sacred part of our body. Here we have the ability to digest and process the food, the ability to recreate, reproduce, and it connects us down to the earth and our water, the fire element. So if you can, I'd like you to visualize a beautiful warm sun rising above
your sacral and your abdominal area. Just visualize a beautiful warm sun rising above your sacral and your abdominal area. A beautiful warm sun rising above your sacral and abdominal area. And as the sun, the warmth, the light rises, it activates the life, of our prithvi, the earth element, the solid element. It also activates the life of our jala, the water element. And it activates the life of the tejas, the energy, the heat, the agni element. So visualizing this beautiful warm sun rising above your sacral and your abdominal area and activating all your life mechanisms. Feeling this deep, this profound connection, touch or union with these beautiful life energies, these beautiful vital energies. And one of the beautiful aspect of Hatha Yoga is to return back home, return back and connect with your body, mind, your energy. Ha, Tha. So the Ha is the solar and the Tha is the lunar. The union of the solar and the lunar, the male, female, Surya, Chandra energies. So I'd like you to feel this deep dynamic connection, the dance or the attuning and intuning between the prithvi, the solid, jala, the water, and then the agni, the heat, the energy elements. And feel them being absolutely active as the sun is rising. And let the sun, let the energy rise and rise gradually, expanding down towards your feet and up towards your heart, your throat and your crown, and your whole body just having this deep merged bathing absorption into the sun. Consciously letting go, totally letting go and surrendering into this beautiful, this energetic space. You have nothing to worry, nothing to fear. Just be in this abundance. A sense of feeling safe, feeling secure. And then letting go and transcending in your space, transcending in your energy. Even now and then reminding ourselves, you are not in a race, you are not here to catch up on anything, not even a deep experience of any of these yogic visions. You're just here to be in the space and let go. Let go and keep doing your practice, keep doing your visualization. Beautiful warm sun rising, melting away everything, all the dark, dull energies, stagnant energies, and letting your elements, your life supportive, creative building blocks to be active, to come alive, and feel that life in your bones, feel the life in your muscles. Feel the life in your organs, your soft tissues beneath your skin. Feel the life in your nervous system, your brain, life in your blood circulation. Even feel the life of your mind. Let them all to be alive, to be active. I'm going to leave you all in this beautiful free space to enjoy experiencing this life.